He was introduced to hockey through my sister and her family. He really looked up to his cousin and would go and watch him play and just would sit there in the bleachers and just be mesmerized and came home and said, I'm gonna play hockey.
As a teenager from Isanti, Minnesota, Matt Olson took his passion for the game to Totino Grace High School in Fridley, where he made the varsity as a freshman.
That was his goal. The summer before, that's what he worked at. Coach Lohr had made the comment, I don't have any choice. I have to put him on the varsity because he deserves it.
He was just a kid who worked really hard. Physically, he was a big enough kid that he wasn't intimidated by being a freshman. He had a presence about him on the ice, and he was a smart hockey player.
In a decorated career at Totino Grace, Olson became the school's all-time Ironman for most games played. As a senior, he captained the Eagles to the state tournament.
Every year he got better as a player, and I think one of the things that we saw, whatever the team needed, Matt was willing to do that. Whatever the team needed to be successful, that's what Matt did.
When he graduated in the spring of 2014, Olson began to play junior hockey with a stated goal to someday play at the collegiate level. In August of last year, he joined the Chicago Cougars, a Tier 3 junior team based in Hoffman Estates, Illinois. And from the outset, he made a lasting impression both on and off the ice.
We've done 9 community service events this year. Food drives, mentoring youth hockey programs, singing to the elderly for Valentine's Day, the Down Syndrome Gigi's Playhouse here in Hoffman Estates, and Matt volunteered for every single function.
Very selfless, one of the first guys to the rink every single day, one of the last guys to leave. Great hockey player, defenseman, co-captain for our team this season with the Cougars. He actually led our team in points for defensemen.
Turning around and shooting, and it is Olson for the goal! Makes it 2-1.
On the night of February 21st, Olson scored the opening goal for the Cougars. But later in the first period, as his parents watched a live stream at their home in Isanti, Matt was racing for a puck behind the net when, untouched, he may have caught an edge and crashed headfirst into the boards.
Sue and I were watching it on TV, and we knew it wasn't good. It was hard. I know standing up after sitting there watching, and my legs were weak.
It's late, it's dark, it's a 7-hour drive. Do we leave now? Do we wait and go in the morning?
As we conversed with people that were at the rink, we knew then that tonight was the night we had to go. It was bad enough that we should get there. It was a long ride. We just prayed the whole way.
That night, a family member drove the Olsons to Advocate Lutheran General Hospital, a level 1 trauma center in Park Ridge, Illinois, where in the wee hours of the morning, Dr. Stephen Marjetko performed surgery on a young man paralyzed from the neck down.
The mechanism of injury in his case is that he hit the board and his body weight carried forward. So the entire weight of his body is focused in this case on the C4 vertebra, which basically exploded. The decision was to proceed with a removal of the C4 vertebra. We used a titanium mesh cage and Matthew's own bone, which we recycle and put back into the cage after we removed the broken bone. So that addressed the immediate needs with regards to decompressing the spinal cord, restabilizing his unstable spine.
In the hours and days and weeks since the injury, Matt and his family have received an outpouring of support. At Totino Grace High School, students and faculty have participated in fundraisers and signed a prayer card of inspirational well wishes. In Chicago, the hockey community has weighed in with a number of fundraising initiatives and volunteer services in a valiant effort to meet the needs of the family who arrive with little more than the clothes on their back.
The support here in Chicago and back home has been phenomenal. I cannot imagine going through this experience without the type of support we've been receiving. It's difficult not being home, but we feel like we have family here. The community has just come together, which has been amazing.
They have a long journey ahead of them, and what we're doing is so small compared to what they're gonna need to follow this journey with Matt through the future. In the hockey community, we're like a family. Matt is like all of our kids.
The journey for Matt and his family began almost immediately as he undergoes physical therapy, occupational therapy, and speech therapy for his damaged larynx.
His next step would be learning how to control his voice using what's called a pacemaker valve. When they get the okay from trauma that the patient is ready, then we can hear Matt's voice, which we all can't wait to hear his voice.
In the meantime, Matt communicates with whispers, a letter board, and facial expressions, which included a major league smile when Andrew Shaw and Andrew Desjardins of the Chicago Blackhawks paid him a visit.
Those two NHL hockey players were in that room visiting Matt for over 90 minutes. Matt kind of gave them a little grief because the Blackhawks lost 5-0 to the Kings the other night. So then Andrew Shaw threw it right back at Matt about Minnesota and the playoffs and stuff. It was awesome.
The future for Matt is fraught with uncertainty. The medical team at Lutheran General has performed an experimental stem cell procedure with the long-term hope of increasing mobility. But one thing is certain, the cost going forward will be staggering.
These injuries are devastating on a personal level, on a human level, on a medical level, but on a financial level, for sure they're devastating to the individual and to the family. His care is going to be ongoing for the remainder of his life. It's likely that this will require many hundreds of thousands of dollars a year in support for the remainder of his life.
Matt Olson needs our support now and in the future. And those that know him best have little doubt that Matt will do his part to make the long road ahead of him a positive experience.
Matt has a sign on his wall that he reads hundreds of times a day. Never quit, be strong, and other sayings on it. I truly think that he's the type of kid that is going to prove everybody wrong.
I think that's probably the one thing that is going to be in Matt's favor more than anything else, is that he is a kid who doesn't quit. This happened for a reason. You know what, God's got a plan, and we don't know what it is, and there's something good that's going to come out of it.
He wanted to share the 23rd Psalm with people. That's something that's important to him, that no matter how hard the journey, that God assures us that he's with us the whole way. I solemnly believe we have that faith that we will get through this with God's help.
Just knowing who Matt is as a person and his passion and his drive to be the best that he can be, being able to adapt to the circumstances, he's a very resilient person. He will make something of this and he will do something special. We just don't know what that is yet,